Eine schwerelose Woche. Mein Außeneinsatz mit der Deutschen Raumfahrtagentur im DLR hat mich auf einen Parabelflug gebracht und neben Interviews mit Wissenschaftlern, Piloten und sogar Astronauten hat mich als Ingenieur natürlich die Technik sehr interessiert. Dass man ein Flugzeug und einen Piloten für diese Flüge braucht, ist glaube ich klar, aber wie in der Raumfahrt gibt es noch viel, viel mehr Menschen am Boden, die dafür sorgen, dass mit der Technik alles in Ordnung ist. In dem englischen Interview heute, mit deutschen Untertiteln übrigens, schauen wir uns das Flugzeug von unten an und fragen die Technik nach den Besonderheiten der A310 Zero-G und was die speziellen Belastungen des Parabelflugs für das Flugzeug bedeuten. Herzlich willkommen zu Senkrechtstarter, dem Raumfahrtkanal im deutschen Sprachraum.
Hey, ich bin hier mit Christoph. I'm here with Christoph. He's in charge for the aircraft. It's a really special aircraft, I will guess. So do you had to do something special to do zero-G flights?
Yes, this is a specific aircraft. It was previously owned by the German Air Force. It was a VIP aircraft of the German Air Force to transport the Chancellor. And when we bought it, we have completely modified the cabin of the aircraft. It was a VIP with a bathroom, a bedroom, a meeting room. So we have removed everything. And then, as you have seen yesterday, we have a full area which is padded with foam everywhere. And this is an empty area where the scientists can install all the equipment. We have also added some electrical converters so that we can provide to the scientists same power supply that they have in laboratories, the same you have at home.
You said it, they or you removed the toilet, so there's no bathroom anymore. So yesterday, the whole flight, I couldn't go to the bathroom, probably because of the fluids, so that you had to remove the toilets.
Yes, exactly. Yes, you remove the toilet because in the toilet there is water, and in zero-G, the water is floating. And we'll leave their container, so we have removed the toilets in the aircraft. These are very short flights, 3-4 hours, so we have some portable toilets in case of necessity.
Fluid is a good word. I mean, you need some fluids to run this aircraft. I mean, you have like fuel, you have like the hydraulic fluid. Is zero-G a problem there?
No, it's not a problem. The aircraft are designed to fly in zero-G, not for a long period of zero-G, but in the certification process of an aircraft, you need to prove that you can pass zero-G phases. So there were some specific studies performed by Airbus and also by General Electric, the provider of the engines, theoretical studies, and also some flight tests to prove that we can do microgravity for 20-25 seconds with fluid moving but without any problem for the proper functioning of the aircraft.
I've heard, I mean, it's an Airbus 310, right? I've heard that it's the largest aircraft to do regular zero-G flights. Is that true?
Yes, that's true. Yes, exactly.
It's amazing.
Yes. They are three main aircraft in the world, one Ilyushin 76 in Russia. It's highest, the cabin is highest, but not so long. There is a Boeing B727 in US, but it's really shorter than our aircraft.
Between the periods of zero gravity, the pilot pulls the aircraft back up, creating positive G-forces. How strong are those forces, and are there a problem for the aircraft, or is it like you have to do this in the certification process for a normal aircraft as well?
Yes, so before the parabola and after the parabola, we have a phase of hypergravity. What we call hypergravity is 1.8 G, which means that your weight is 1.8 G more than on Earth. So the aircraft are designed for minus 0.5 G to plus 2.5 G. So we are in the flight envelope of the aircraft. This is not a problem for the aircraft, but due to the repetition of this hypergravity, zero gravity, and so on, there is a fatigue effect on the structure of the aircraft. And Airbus made some fatigue studies on the structure of the aircraft and defined some coefficient of equivalence between standard flight and parabolic flight. So we have a coefficient, and this coefficient multiplies the maintenance task threshold and interval, which means that for the aircraft is more maintained than a standard aircraft. For example, for the wing, there is a coefficient of 35, which means that all the maintenance inspection to be done on the wing are done 35 more time more than for a standard aircraft. So there is an important maintenance on the structure of the aircraft.
The aircraft is not that much in the air like a normal airliner for like Air France, right? But you have like similar intervals, even that you're flying less? Or
yes, in fact, in the maintenance program, there are what we call calendar tasks. They are weekly tasks, daily tasks, monthly. So either you fly or not, you have to do this task, maintenance task. You have also tasks which are defined based on the use of the aircraft. Every, for instance, 500 a cycle, you have to do such a task. So the calendar tasks are done for Air France, your example. But the other tasks which are linked to flight cycle or flight hours are done based on the real use of the aircraft.
And had you ever some defects or something specifically that is due to this gravity flights?
No. There is no specific defect. As I told before, there was a huge certification done on the aircraft. So a lot of studies, a lot of tests, and the aircraft is working really properly, and there is nothing, no defect related to the microgravity use of the aircraft.
And how long do you think is the aircraft possible to go on and to do these experiments?
It should fly until about 2035. At this time, it will have reached what we call the extended service goal, is a limitation, age limitation defined by Airbus.
So a little bit more than 10 years still for fun in this aircraft and still for good result for the scientific people. Yeah. And I wish you that you do not have to maintain it so much and can enjoy and have fun with this aircraft. And
thanks a lot, but we have a chance to, this aircraft is a very good aircraft and good for the quality of the parabola, but also very reliable and really efficient. So we are really happy. We had before an A300, now we have an A310, and both are very good aircraft.
Cool. Thank you so much.
You're welcome, with pleasure.
Das war mein Technik-Interview zum A310 Zero-G. Ich hoffe, dir hat es wieder gefallen. Dann den Like nicht vergessen. Nach den ganzen spannenden Interviews geht es in der nächsten Folge dann in die Luft und ich nehme euch mit auf mein Abenteuer Schwerelosigkeit. Wenn du das nicht verpassen magst, genau, dann hier Senkrechtstarter abonnieren. Hier geht natürlich wieder ein riesen Dankeschön an alle Schutzengel. Ohne euch wäre diese Reise überhaupt nicht möglich gewesen und ohne euch würde es Senkrechtstarter so nicht geben. Hashtag Team Space. Ich würde sagen, bis zum nächsten Mal. Immer schön senkrecht bleiben. Dein Mo.